Okay. Good morning, South Plainfield. Today is Tuesday, March 22nd, 2023. I'm Emma Ballinger.
And I'm Jake Shapiro, and you're watching Tiger TV.
Wow.
Oh, sorry.
Tickets to see The Wedding Singer will be available to purchase during your lunch period starting on Friday in the cafeteria. Tickets are $10. They are also available to purchase at the door the day of the show. Attention seniors. This Friday at 3 p.m., the local scholarship will close. Don't miss out on an opportunity for a scholarship. Fill out the application and submit it to Ms. Pileggi by 3 p.m. this Friday. I can't read. The cast of the Apple TV hit show Ted Lasso made a brief appearance in the White House press briefing room to talk about mental health, which is a popular theme in the show. Series creator and star Jason Sudeikis, along with other cast members, took questions from the podium, even from fictitious Trent Crim, the sports critic on the show.
So like, no matter who you are, no matter where you live, no matter who you voted for, we all know someone who has, or have been that someone ourselves, actually, that's struggled, that's felt isolated, that's felt anxious, that has felt alone, right? And it's actually one of the many things that, believe it or not, that we all have in common as human beings, right? And so that means that it's something that we can all, you know, and should talk about with one another when we're feeling that way, or when we recognize that in someone feeling that way. So please, you know, we encourage everyone, and this is a big theme of the show, is like to check in with your, you know, your neighbor, your coworker, your friends, your family, and ask how they're doing, and listen sincerely. You know, I mean, you all ask questions for a living.
Video. The World Baseball Classic is winding down, and outside of the Mets fans seeing their season possibly ending before it began, Team Italy was gaining headlines for openly using performance enhancers in the dugout. Team Italy, led by former Mets great Mike Piazza, had an espresso machine next to the Gatorade and Big League Chew. Even embracing all the stereotypes, they even had the little barista Crystal Rock stir sticks. After the team was eliminated, it was announced that all players will be replaced by Chris Pratt.
It's a me, baseball.
Baseball. This Thursday, March 23rd, marks the first day of Ramadan for Muslims across the world. Ramadan is a holy month of fasting, prayer, reflection, and community. In Islam, Ramadan is meant to teach the practice of self-control and self-discipline by refraining from eating during the time period between sunrise and sunset. It also teaches followers to have empathy for the less fortunate, encouraging the spread of generosity and charity. Ramadan will come to an end on Friday, April 21st, which will be followed by the celebration of Eid, the Islamic holiday that celebrates the completion of Ramadan. That's about it for Medina's magical remarks.
I'm Lisa Sakura, and I'm going to be exposing people's heights. Who am I here with? And how tall are you?
5'11".
Can I see your lie?
Sure.
Riley, you're 5'10".
No. I'm not 5'10". No, get it close, because you're half.
Wait, you're 5'10 and a half.
No, literally, because she...
Who am I here with?
Z.
How tall are you?
Offset.
Can we see if you're lying? Oh, no, without the hair, without the hair.
Yeah, without the hair.
Definitely like,
without the hair is like 5'5", Zane.
What in the world?
Who am I here with?
Matt.
How tall are you?
6'4".
Can we see if you're lying?
Sure.
The whole thing is like cooking.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
I can't do that.
I can't even tell.
It's like...
I was counting the hair.
6'5".
Five.
I guess I'm not lying.
Now to Jake's news. Speaking of the Mets, workers are getting Citi Field ready for opening day and firing up the scoreboard for the first time with a massive Mario Kart race on the screen. The Tiger TV I'd Rather Be Safe Driving Design Competition ends next week. If you have an eye for design, create a shirt graphic that promotes safe driving, and you could win prizes and have your design put on your promo material. That's pretty cool.
Very cool.
Good Burger, I wasn't gonna do that, sorry. Good Burger, Home Good Burger is coming back. Good Burger 2 has been greenlit at Paramount Plus with original stars Kenan Thompson and Kel Mitchell set to return. The sequel to the beloved Nickelodeon film will begin production in May and debut on Paramount Plus later in 2023. It follows Dexter Reed and the beloved goofball Ed as they try to get back on their feet after another one of their inventions fails. The film has archived cult classic status, with the Mitchell and Thompson reuniting for a Good Burger sketch on The Tonight Show in 2015 and a recent spoof sketch on Saturday Night Live with actress Kiki Palmer. Adam Sandler has become the first recipient of over 15 Razzie Awards to also be awarded the Mark Twain Prize for American Humor. At the induction ceremony at the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C., Sandler discussed his love for employing his friends. Judd Apatow, Chris Rock, Jennifer Aniston, Drew Barrymore, Conan O'Brien, and Steve Buscemi recalled Sandler's boundless confidence during his early days in L.A. and shared an old video of Sandler workshopping various voices while prank calling a local deli. Sandler also joked that one day his award might be used to bludge him in his sleep. Congrats to Mr. Sandler.
That's it for today's announcements.
Have a great day, South Plainfield. Cut it out.
I can't remember any of the other ones.
You got it, dude.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot. That was like,
what,
any
what
other?
What was Aunt Becky's?
Aunt Becky did not have
she
a line.
She had one.
A one-liner
sure
from
did.
Aunt Becky? Besides,
sure
give me
did.
Some, besides pay for my college kids?
Guys, Shannon's back from Florida.